Climate change is reshaping our world with rising temperatures and more frequent natural disasters in the past decades. The primary cause is the burning of fossil fuels, which releases greenhouse gases that trap heat in the atmosphere. According to the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, we need to limit global warming within 1.5 degrees Celsius above pre-industrial levels in order to reduce the risks associated with climate change. Transitioning to electric vehicles and renewable energy sources like solar and wind is vital for achieving this target. However, as these new industries boom, we are also seeing negative impacts on workers and communities that we are not properly prepared for. In this video, let's examine some of the human costs associated with the transition to renewable energy. To understand the problems, let's take a closer look at three key components required for the green energy transition: solar panels for generating solar energy, wind turbines for generating wind energy, and rechargeable batteries used in electric vehicles, mobile phones, and other electronic devices. Key minerals such as aluminium, cobalt, copper, lithium, nickel, and zinc are essential for the manufacturing of these components. These are often known as transition minerals or critical minerals, as they are critical in the transition to renewable energy. According to IMF estimates, the demand for lithium, for example, is projected to surge tenfold from year 2022 to 2050, primarily driven by the growing demand for batteries used in electric vehicles. As the demand for these critical minerals surges, they are being mined in new locations by some of the most vulnerable people, employed by companies operating in countries with some of the weakest legal protection for workers and communities. In the Democratic Republic of Congo, DRC, the country that has the world's highest reserves of cobalt, a metal used in batteries of mobile phones, laptop computers, and other electronic devices, Amnesty International documented how thousands of children and informal workers are employed in artisanal mines, digging with only basic hand tools and minimal protective equipment. Many lose their lives in mine collapses or suffer long-term health problems due to exposure to toxic substances. The expansion of cobalt and copper mines has also led to forced eviction of entire communities, along with other abuses including sexual assault, arson, and beatings. Nickel is another key mineral that plays a critical role in the manufacturing of batteries for electric vehicles. Indonesia is the world's largest nickel producer, but mining activities are causing deforestation, water pollution, and other environmental harms. There has been widespread clearing of forests across Indonesia to make way for nickel mining. Many of these forests are important natural carbon sinks and critical biodiversity areas. Nickel refineries in Indonesia's industrial parks rely heavily on power generated from dirty, captive, coal-fired plants, resulting in very high greenhouse gas emissions and air pollution. This reliance on coal contradicts the essence of the energy transition and serves as a prime example of greenwashing, where underlying ecological harms are masked by overstated environmental benefits. To make matters worse, water pollution from mining and refining nickel has threatened the ancestral homes and livelihoods of indigenous peoples. Access to food has also been affected as dust from the mines covers local crops. In the nickel refineries, serious accidents frequently occur under lax regulations and monitoring. In December 2023 alone, several explosions and fires occurred at various refineries, resulting in the deaths of at least 21 workers and seriously injuring dozens more. The Xinjiang Uyghur Autonomous Region in northwest China produces 45% of the world's solar-grade polysilicon, a key material used in most solar panels. A report by Sheffield Hallam University found that all polysilicon manufacturers in the region participate in the government's labor transfer programs or are supplied by companies that do. For many years, these labor transfer programs, involving over 1 million indigenous Uyghur and Kazakh citizens, have been associated with forced labor. Evidence reveals that labor transfers are implemented in an environment of unprecedented coercion, with constant threats of re-education and internment. Many workers are unable to refuse or leave these jobs. 90 companies that source solar panel components from the region, including both Chinese and international companies, have their supply chains linked to forced labor in this region, making a major part of the global solar supply chain complicit in these serious human rights violations. As we emphasized earlier, the renewable energy sector is crucial for transitioning to a net zero carbon global economy, as climate change will affect everyone and our future generations. So we all have a vested interest in the sector's success. Unfortunately, as we have seen in this video, there have also been some troubling human rights abuses within the sector. But decarbonizing the global economy shouldn't lead to further human rights violations of its own. As consumers, we should advocate for companies to prioritize transparency, traceability, and accountability. Brand companies from whom we buy our products have the leverage to monitor and select ethical suppliers to source their raw materials from. This is where traceability becomes crucial, as it enables companies to track and trace the journey of products, materials, and components from their origins to final consumers. This is also important for the renewable energy sector, as it allows companies and other stakeholders to detect exploitative working conditions or negative impacts on communities more easily, so that when problems are found, they can be addressed quickly. When we buy our electronic devices or electric cars, when making purchasing decisions as consumers, we should consider supporting companies that prioritize human rights and sustainable practices. Some countries, particularly in Europe, are also starting to pass more stringent laws to ensure that companies assess and address their environmental and human rights impacts throughout their supply chains. So what do you think? Do these issues in the renewable energy sector surprise you? What can be done to reduce these unintended social and environmental impacts of the transition into clean energy? Let us know in the comments below. Give us a thumbs up. Also, check out our video about Indigenous people's rights and subscribe to Channel CSR for more videos about responsible business practices.